time is it, Eric?
To time is smoked chanterelle rosé sauce time. Rosé sauce. Rosé sauce. That is in the booklet. Recipes, rosé sauce.
Page eight.
Saute some onion and garlic, and bacon is optional. You can use veggie bacon, you can omit the bacon part.
Doesn't need bacon.
I really like bacon.
Most guys want bacon, most girls don't.
Yeah, it's true. Once that's sauteed, you have to remember while you're doing that, you soak your mushrooms. Save that soaking water. Again, food processor or dice up fine. Don't leave these whole. You want to dice them up so that everybody gets some.
Oh, can I interrupt you, Eric?
Well, you have already.
I did. Stop jumping. So with the chanterelles, you want to give the stem a squeeze. When the stem is soft and pinchable, then they're ready to go. Because they are a little more dense than the other mushrooms.
All right. Add your chopped, alder smoked, wine cask aged chanterelles into your sauteed onion and garlic and butter.
So those, that's just kind of a quick saute, but you want to let them golden, just like everything, right? You let, this is the part where you want to take your time. Give it that few extra minutes. Let it get nice and golden.
Oh, it smells good.
It smells really good. It
smells like bacon, actually.
You know, you want your onions kind of brown, and you want your mushrooms with the little color on the outside.
After you've got a nice crisp on your mushrooms, your onions, garlic, bacon in there, then you're going to add the water you soaked them in.
And you're going to leave a little,
all but the last little bit. Now that will reduce. Our soaking water has reduced now. And so now we get to deglaze the pan. Pull the gooey bits off the bottom of the pan with a couple tablespoons of wine. Of course, you can use de-alcoholized wine, but you should know too, if you are sensitive to alcohol, you know, if it makes you dizzy or whatever, then you can use no wine.
What you got there, Eric?
This is a cup of cream. Now I'm gonna add a little bit of salt and pepper. And we're gonna add our cup of diced fresh tomato, because this is a rosé sauce, after all. And we're going to simmer this for about 10-15 minutes. You can thicken this with a little bit of flour and water if you like, as we did with the morel sauce. But right, that's pretty much perfect. That's how I like it right there.
You can reduce it as much as you want and let it sit as much as you want.
Let's put a little bit of this on some pasta. Just like that. Oh, yeah. And then that is ready to serve.
Delish.
You like that one?